Hi, this is Scott Garibay, and today we're going to talk about Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition, and we are specifically going to talk about the movie Love Hard and a Powerful Lesson for Every Dungeon Master from the movie Love Hard 2021. Spoilers for the movie Love Hard 2021 in this content. And basically, I want to talk about scent and how important scent is in to player characters and how they perceive the world, and how we as dungeon masters have this ability to use scent in our games to really bring the world alive and to break our players through to an immersive, an unbound immersive experience, and to truly unlock the value of unbound identity for them. All right, let's get into this. All right, so Love Actually 2021, 5 out of 5 star movie. Absolutely fantastic. It is every Dungeon Master content for all Dungeon Masters over 18. You really need to see this thing because it's just masterfully crafted from the perspective of writing, right? Writing is a discipline that you need to... A discipline that you need to master as a dungeon master. If you're gonna be a dungeon master, you need to be a master of writing, right? It's a discipline that others get an entire lifetime to work on. As us dungeon masters, it's literally a bullet point. If you haven't experienced my bullet point series, you'll find it right here on my channel. All right, so let's get into this. It's really incredible. So, Love Hard 2021 is just a spectacular film. That shows how good writing is established and is done and then distributed. It's just spectacular. And one of the ways that Love Hard 2021 becomes a 5 out of 5 star film, becomes every Dungeon Master content, great art, is it uses scent extremely, actually uses scent better in any film I've ever seen before. I've never seen a film that used scent as well as Love Hard 2021. All right, so Love Hard is about Jimmy Yang's character, right? I'm just going to refer to his character as Jimmy Yang. Jimmy Yang is the actor in the movie. His name is Josh Lin, so I'll use his character name, Josh Lin. So Josh Lin in the movie is a young, short Asian man, right? And I'm not calling that out just to, like, call out, you know, Josh Lin as a character. It's how they describe him in the film. And he has distinct problems in his life based on these attributes, right? He's like, my life has problems because I'm a young, short Asian man, right? And the movie explores, like, the experience of young, short Asian men, right? And tells me about problems I did not know they had, right? And it's really excellent. But one of the things that Jimmy does is he works for his father at an outdoor store, right? So he sells, like, kayaks and, just outdoor, and he sells sports equipment, and he's terrible at it. And his father, like, built the business from the ground up, right? But what he does in his own time is he makes candles. All right, so let's talk about Josh Lin makes candles. So let's talk about candles for a minute. I detest candles. I hate them with a passion, and my wife loves me so much because she likes candles. We don't really use them in my house because they freak me out hard. Like, I really don't like candles. What I consider a candle is like, hey, would you like a dice roll if your house is going to burn to the ground? My answer is no. I don't really want to see if my house is going to burn down today. Like, I would really rather not wonder if my house will be in existence today. I really dislike candles. Because I feel like it's just a fire, an open flame you put in your house. It just seems like the most ridiculous bad idea ever. And I detest them. I really don't like them. I don't like them in my house. I don't like to see them anywhere else. I'm always like, did somebody knock that candle over and this whole house is going to burn to the ground? Right? Like, they really freak me out. Like, I know it sounds strange, but I'm very, very uncomfortable with candles. Right? So, with that, you know, with me stating I'm very uncomfortable with candles, right? Where does that lead, right? So you would expect that I would very much not like, a film that actually talks, you know, that gets into candles the way this film does, because Josh Lin's character loves candles and makes candles, right? Now, it does. The movie has a great little aspect where he is making candles for men. And I didn't know this, but the vast majority of candle, the movie says that the vast majority of candle purchasers are women. And the reason why is that men are underserved in the candle industry, right? So the movie puts that forward. And so the movie has all these great names for the, these candles. You know, like one of his candles is called Lawnmower. And one of his one of the candles is called Gray Day, right? And but one of his candles, and this is where the movie really took off, and I just did think it just did an absolutely fantastic job. You know, like this is what was really special about the film. One of the candles that Josh made was called Grandpa, right? And his father at one point actually picks up the candle and says, "What is this?" And he smells it, and Josh had to hide that he was making candles because he was convinced his dad would be ashamed of him, right? Because this isn't something that men generally do, right? And his dad says, "Oh my gosh, this smells like your granddad." And he's like, "Yes." And so he's like, "This smells like, you know, it smells like," what did he say again? "Like mahogany wood and varnish." And then the last part, he's like, "There's something else there." And he's like, and Jocelyn is like, "Bengay," right? You're like, and so you just laugh, and it's really, but the idea that you could create a candle that when it was smelled, a person who had known another person, that the candle would remind them of that one person. Like, holy cows, that's incredible. What an incredible concept, right? And it was just really delightful and wonderful. And I was really impressed with this concept of the candle reminding somebody of a specific person, right? And I have to say, like, the way the film did it, the way they set it up, I actually cried when his father, you know, actually smelled the candle and said, "This smells like granddad," you know, like this smells like grandpa, right? And actually, that is what he had named the candle, like, he called it grandpa, right? And the reason why I cried was it was just beautiful, right? Because I hate candles, and I have no idea why people like them, right? But when I realized, you know, we are sensory beings, right? We are humans. Scent is powerfully connected to memory, right? And of course, Grandpa in the movie is dead, right? Like, and Josh had created this thing where the moment anyone smelled the candle who have ever encountered his grandfather, their grandfather was right there with them immediately. Like, it was like they were resurrecting the grandfather, because scent is so powerfully connected to memory, right? So we as dungeon masters, we have this ability, right? So if you read books, or if you watch television shows, or if you watch movies, or if you play video games, you're trapped in these sad, antiquated stories, right? They're being told for the masses. They're not told for you. They're told for millions of people, right? We as dungeon masters are custom crafting tales to four distinct people, right? And when we do that, we are allowing them to add an additional life to their current life. We're saying, you are no longer bound to your one life. You are going to have new memories, new passions, new talents, new sensory palettes. You will smell things with this other life that you have never smelled in your life. You smell what it smells like when an oak is burnt by the breath weapon of a bronze dragon, right? That is a scent that lives in my heart and in my mind, right? Because I encountered it with Kynwin, my half-orc cleric. I don't know, as Scott Garibay, what that smells like exactly, but Kynwin, a life I lived for about 6 months, made many decisions, you know, achieved some of my passions, achieved some of my goals, experienced other passions that Scott Garibay doesn't have, achieved goals that Scott Garibay never set, right? And so Kynwin has this sense memory, right? This smell of what an oak burned by the breath weapon of a bronze dragon smells like, right? That's incredible, right? Like, and I really think that Love Hard, you know, I don't care about,
I didn't care about candles. I didn't get it, right? Like, I really dislike candles. But there are many people in this world who love candles, right? And so one of the things that we have to do as dungeon masters is get out of our own space and telling people what, you know, and telling people through this limited lens of our own preferences. We, you know, and so one of the things we need to use scent, S-C-E-N-T, to unlock these additional lives we're granting players, right? And we accomplish unbound immersion for these player characters, right? So unbound immersion means we're going to immerse them in this world that we've created for them. And you can do that incredibly powerfully with scent. You can ground them in these worlds that we're creating for them in a way that no other perception tool like sight or touch or hearing or taste can do, right? So we really, as dungeon masters, really need to do a great job and be focused on delivering for our player characters with scent, S-C-N-T. And I highly encourage you, if you are a dungeon master and you want to be better, right? You want to draw players, the best players possible in your local area. You want to take players from dungeon masters in your local area who are not doing a good job at creating unbound immersion, understanding unbound identity, right? And you want to create a space where peak path Dungeons and Dragons occurs, right? Use scent and look at Love Hard 2021. It will ground you in how powerful scent is, and it'll help you to be a better dungeon master. All that's my opinion. Love to hear your thoughts. Let me know in the comments below. Please consider liking and subscribing, and have a wonderful millennium.